Hi Christina, lovely to meet up with you again at the range and do some further work on your game. I can't wait to see how this progresses over the next month, because by the end of this session we're really getting somewhere with it. What we saw at the start of your session was a much better version of the swing that you made on your first visit, but still trending towards that cut pattern where the arms drift out too much. And as you discussed, you've been trying to combat that over the past 3 years without having, or with having, variable degrees of success, certainly able to do it out on the range. Intermittently, but not being able to carry it out on the golf course. So what we've got is a little bit too much outward movement of the butt of the golf club during the transition. There's a little bit of a lifting of the arms as you complete the backswing, and then the outward aspect of the downswing, the turn into the body, is pulling the club out too much. And at P5, when the left arm's parallel with the floor, the shaft's hitting you at the sort of base of your shoulder stroke, neck, where your neck meets your shoulder. So the first thing we talked about was giving some thought to the direction you want the butt of the club to work during the transition. And what you can see here is we're trying to work the butt of the club down. And when we do that, we get the shaft more in line with the right shoulder. And from there, we're much less likely to hit a big pull or a cut. We then refined that a little bit, because what you were saying is that changed the picture and you understood the concept of that, but you were having great difficulty actually feeling that. So what we've done here is we've laid out a spectrum of push shots out on the range, and we're asking you at the moment to hit this big push. That's the feel. Okay, now the act of hitting the push causes you to lift the arms less. On the way back, we can see that at P4 we're much shorter and deeper, and we'd expect to see that. I fully expect to see that become a little bit more upright as you start to hit the medium push and then the smaller push. Ideally, we'd want the ball starting off just right of the cane, so that small push would be where we're working towards. But ultimately, to get here, we've got to shift everything over to the right for a spell and make a big shift to the right initially. So from there now, when hitting the push, that's encouraging you to keep the arms in more. It's encouraging you to turn less. And you can see the difference now at P5. The shaft is much more in. We play that down now to your delivery position, P6. Club now is inside your hands, as opposed to way outside your hands. We'll just synchronize these two swings on the far ends. You can see the difference now in the angle of attack and the angle of approach of the golf club. You can see on the left where the occasional shank will come from. As the arms work out away from you, that's presenting the neck of the club to the ball. We're hitting out at the golf ball for longer. You can see on the far right, the hand's still visible. The exit is higher, and there's less gap between the knees, denoting that there's been much less turning and flexing through impact. When we videoed that from face on, there was a marked improvement in your ability to slide your hips. So this is a case of calming down the rate at which you rotate and turn from the top, which in turn reduces the amount of outward force applied to the golf club, which helps you keep the club inside and hit out at the golf ball, producing pushes, push draws. You can see the difference in the trajectory on the two shots. The nice high push on the right, we just got to learn to bring that back now, which we can do in subsequent sessions. And to be honest with you, once you get the hang of this, you'll figure out how to bring that back anyway. You'll do that by your own devices. So between now and when we get together at the start of April, keep hammering away at that big push, keep working on the other exercises that we did on your first and second visit. But that really is a huge change and a dramatic difference in ball flight and starting direction compared to where you were at the start of your session. Well done, good luck, and if you have any questions, feel free to contact me. Well done.